Welcome to Eaton Square. This is Davey. We are going to do an online virtual PE session for you guys. Myself, Michael and Martin will be involved. Martin on the spot. Marching on the spot. So, just going to be marching like this to warm you up. What we're trying to do is when your left foot comes up, your right arm comes up as well. So keep the coordination strong. So like this. Okay? So we're just going to do this on marching on the spot for about 20 seconds. Coordination, so opposite arm, opposite leg, so in slow motion it should look something like this. Alright, we're going to speed it up, 20 seconds. Okay, then let's get you on the spot, well done. I'm running on the spot. Number three is running on the spot. So, like skipping, right, and marching, but a little bit quicker. Running on the spot. So what we're doing, we're looking to raise our heart rate. Keep those feet moving, lift those knees, pump those arms. Keep focused, 20 seconds. Arm rotations. Four is arm rotations. So now we worked a little bit on the lower body, we're going to work on the upper body. So we're going to start with arm rotations. Out in front of you, we're going to circle them inwards, like this. We'll do 10 seconds each. And try outside, 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then above our head for 10 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 10, and that completes our fourth arm. Balancing. Okay, exercise number five is balancing. So we're gonna take one leg off the floor, bend our knees. We can use our arms, right? So elevate our arms for balance. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, good. And then the other side, 10 seconds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That completes
the exercise. Squats. Squats. So right, you need to put your two arms up. You need to just bend down, just go long. So we're gonna do this for 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is exercise number 7, star jumps. So we're gonna do 15 star jumps. So legs together, and then just bring them outwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Fast food. Fast food. right? And all we're gonna do as quick demo is left foot forward, right foot forward, left foot back, right foot back. But we're gonna do it for 10 seconds, we're gonna do it quick test like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And to balance up, what we do with our one side, our left side we do with our right. So it's right foot forward, left foot forward, right foot back, left foot back. So 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And that concludes exercise 8. Speed jumps. It's speed jumps. So you can use a row of cones like this, or you can use a sock. Right, using the socks like this.
Speed jump alternative.
Sock. So basically, it's similar to speed jump, but we place two hands on the floor, one side, feet up like this, and then we jump on the other side.
Speed jumps forward and backwards.
Forwards and backwards, this is exercise 9. So 2 feet forward.
Catching.
Oh, using equipment. You could use either a tennis ball or you can use a sock. If you're using a sock, start with the bottom end of the sock where your feet goes in, roll it up, open the top. Parent might want to help for this one, or be the brother or sister. And make a ball. So we're just going to use underarm throw. Just in the pocket. Start with throw, catch. Throw, catch. Throw, catch. Throw, catch. But we want about 10. Right? If you're using a ball, like this.
Catching. Variable heights.
I'm using equipment. Again, you can use a tennis ball, or if you've got a fruit, orange, etc., a small ball, or a sock. Probably a sock. It's nice and soft. Use one sock, I would suggest, rather than two, to not make it too bulky. This one is throwing and catching, but we're going to vary the height of which you catch the ball or the item. All right, the sock in this case. So we'll start with the sock. All right, we're going to throw it up. We're going to catch it as close to the floor as possible. Again, throw it up. We're going to catch it as close to the floor as possible. Throw it up. Catch it to the floor. Throw it up. Catch it to the floor. If we're using a tennis ball, it's exactly the same. Throw it up. Catch it close to the floor. Throw it up. Close to the floor. Throw it up. Close to the floor. Just to show you, if you're catching, it's a good idea to bend one knee rather than both. So if we throw it up, if I stand up and demonstrate again, throw it up. Bend one knee, catch. Eyes on the ball, keep your palms of your hands together. You're going to close your palm around the ball. So throw it up here, close it.
Catching technique.
Just for the catching, to give you an idea of catching, we have our hands like a book. So we open the book and then we close the book to catch it. So if I demonstrate, open the book and then we close it. open the book, you close the book, catch it. Open the book, close the book, catch it.
Throw, clap, catch.
And then we have to stay on the spot as well, that's the aim. What did I just do? Four or five?
Four.
So can't move your feet.
Catching. Variation three.
Yeah, good. And again.
This is for the more advanced ones, hopefully.
Catching. Variation four.
Yeah. Just show a couple of fails.
Yeah.
If this happens.
Okay.
Try again. One hand catching.
We'll start with the tennis ball. So we're going to throw it with one hand, catch it with the other. Throw it with one hand, catch it to the other. So this is more one hand catching rather than two. It's a little more difficult, but have a try. Try and do 10, 7, 8, 9, 10. So if we're using the socks, the same thing, throw one hand, catch it with the other. It's softer, poses a little bit more difficulty by ground. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
One hand catching, variation one.
Tennis ball, a cone, just something that can catch the ball inside. We're going to do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
One hand catching, variation 2. Throwing, variation one.
I wouldn't use two hands for this.
No. Just for the ball, yeah.
Throwing, variation two.
So one right hand. The leg. If they look at the technique as well. We've done that one.
Well done, reception. Keep practicing. Goodbye.